As most of you know, this is a very important week in labor history. March 25th is the 100th anniversary of the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory fire that took place in New York City and took the lives of 146 garment workers, men and women, some of them as young as 14 and 15, mostly women. Men and women, but mostly women. And that's a theme that we're going to hear more about during the course of the morning and afternoon. This morning, you're going to hear how the Triangle Fire changed the course of labor history and opened the nation's eyes to the terrible and abusive working conditions of millions of their fellow citizens. The shocking way the victims of the fire died helped bring about sweeping reforms in workplaces and put in place fire safety codes that caught on across the country. My organization, the National Consumers League, has a very special relationship to the fire because Frances Perkins, who went on to become the first female labor secretary for four terms under FDR, was actually a National Consumers League, the head of the New York office of the National Consumers League when the fire took place. And she, with her own eyes, witnessed as she ran from a friend's house where she was having tea, witnessed these young women and some men, mostly young women, jumping to their deaths because the fire had swept across, particularly the ninth floor where the doors were locked. And it was seared on her memory, and she was determined and pledged that she would never forget this incident. And she spent her life making sure that she would work to better conditions for working men and women. So today's program will begin with a panel that will provide a historical look at the conditions in New York City at the time of the fire. They are sitting here ready to go. The next panel will then discuss the fire in the context of today's workplace conditions. As you listen to the speakers, I urge you to pay close attention to the parallels from 1911 and working conditions today. After the second panel, we're going to take a short break where you'll grab lunch. And over lunch, we're going to watch a short documentary film that was produced for this very event here today. That film looks back at the tragic Triangle Fire, the labor reforms that ensued, and the status of workplace safety in America today. After the film, we're fortunate to have United Mine Worker President Cecil Roberts as our keynote speaker. He will be accompanied by Stanley Goose Stewart. Goose is his nickname. Mr. Stewart's a worker who actually survived the Upper Big Branch mine collapse. He was actually on his way to the shift when the mine collapsed. And that happened only April of last year, and it killed 29 of his fellow miners. Mr. Stewart's going to speak to us for a few minutes about his experience, and he will be followed by President Cecil Roberts' keynote. And if you've never heard President Roberts give an address, I think you will be riveted by his message, moved by his message and his passion. So we will close today's symposium with a brief press conference after President Roberts speaks and take this opportunity to deliver our call to action, which is in all of your packets. That call to action is really a manifesto that includes five very modest demands, including closing loopholes in work safety and mine safety laws that contribute to the daily toll of injuries and fatalities. And I think it's very interesting that we're in the House office building. There are people in offices around us, elected members of Congress, who are in a position to make those laws come to fruition. And I hope that they're getting our good vibes this morning. Now, before I move to our first panel, I want to bring up John Cardinal from Senator Kirsten Gillibrand's office. John was very helpful in getting a wonderful resolution passed in the Senate, and he's going to take a moment to read that resolution and tell you who the co-sponsors are. So John, come on up.
Well, thank you, Sally, and good morning, everyone. Thank you for allowing me to attend your event this morning. As Sally mentioned, we worked on a resolution last week and successfully got it passed by unanimous consent, recognizing the 100th anniversary of the Triangle Shirtwaist Fire. I should also mention that Representative Nadler has a similar resolution on the House side. And the two co-sponsors of our resolution on the Senate side were Senator Schumer and Senator Murray. And I should also say that the senator wishes she could have been here this morning herself. She's up in the state for the week since it's recess and plans on attending similar events towards the end of the week in New York City. So we will be commemorating the event up there in the state. The resolution said that recognizing the 100th anniversary of the Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire in New York City on March 21st, 1911, and designating the week of March 21st, 2011 through March 25th, 2011 as the 100th anniversary of the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory Fire Remembrance Week. Whereas the Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire was the deadliest industrial disaster in the city of New York's history and resulted in the fourth greatest loss of fire of life from an industrial accident in the history of the United States, claiming the lives of 146 garment workers, many of whom were young immigrants. Whereas this human catastrophe exposed the need to strengthen labor laws, fire regulations, and health and safety protections for workers. Whereas the Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire helped spur the growth of modern-day organized labor movement, particularly the International Ladies Garment Workers Union, which continued to fight for better conditions for sweatshop workers. Whereas from the ashes of this horrific event emerged the modern celebration of International Women's Day and the death of 129 women workers in the Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire demonstrated the need for workers' rights and women's rights. Whereas more than 5,000 workers lose their lives each year on the job, and protecting the health and safety of workers continues to be a critical issue in the United States today. And whereas national events will be held to remember the victims of the Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire and to educate citizens about the important role this tragic event played in the history of the United States, now, therefore, be it resolved that the Senate designates the week of March 21st, 2011 through March 25th, 2011 as the 100th anniversary of the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory Fire Remembrance Week. Thank you, everyone.
And they said you couldn't get anything unanimous passed through the Senate. Thank you so much for that, John. Before I introduce the moderator of our first panel, there's some people I'd like to acknowledge. First, I'd like to ask members of the planning committee for this event to stand up and be recognized, and recognize board members of the National Consumers League as well, including our board chair, is Jane King here? Jane? Okay, there you are, Jane. Our board chair, Jane King. I also want to thank, and you can stand for a moment, I want to thank Teresa, Carol, and Daniel, who worked throughout the weekend to get ready for today's symposium, and ask to recognize them as well. And if you don't want to stand, just hold your arm up. But we want everybody who was on the planning committee, because it was a lot of hard work and a lot of meetings, to know that this is not just an NCL thing. This is a coalition effort, and we're fortunate enough to be able to have been part of this very important committee. And finally, I'd like to ask the law firm of Bernstein and Lipset and the Public Welfare Foundation for the public support they provided to make this symposium possible. So thanks to that. And I'm about to introduce our moderator, Sarah Manzano-Diaz. But before, if Sarah, if you'll permit me, I'm going to read a poem from the just to get us in the mode to think about what happened 100 years ago. The poem is from Fragments from the Fire by Chris Llewellyn. She's actually a Washington, D.C. poet, and it's called I Am Appalled, from New York Governor Dix. The police commissioner points to the mayor, who gripes at the governor, I am appalled, and who sets on the state labor commissioner, who blames the national fire underwriters, who turn on the fire commissioner, who cites the city beautiful for finding fire escapes ugly, who then faults the architects, who place it on the tenement housing, who says failure of the health department, who then proclaim conspiracy between the utility companies and the police commissioner. Okay, now, kind of says it all. It's still happening today, we know that.